Previously, you saw how video could be edited into the sequence. Let's have a look at some of the basics of moving around the sequence and the navigational tools. You can drag the sequence positioner all over the sequence to display the current frame in the record viewer. If you want the positioner to jump to another point in time, simply click on the timecode bar beneath the sequence. To navigate to a specific timecode, you can click on the timecode indicator and enter in the value. After pressing enter, the positioner will jump to the specific timecode in the sequence. Another tip is that you can click on the timecode indicator and type the amount of frames you want to advance. For example, if I type 5 frames and press add, the positioner will advance by only 5 frames. You can keep clicking add to keep advancing by 5 frames. The small horizontal bar that crosses the positioner is called the focus point. You will discover that it has many functions in the sequence, and the first function is track navigation. Pressing the previous and next transition buttons, you can see that the positioner is moving from one cut to another along the track aligned with the focus point. So moving the focus point up and down between the tracks allows you to choose which track to navigate. If you want the positioner to snap at every cut on every track, you can force it to do so by pressing Control Up Arrow or Control Down Arrow. In a long or complex edit, you may want to focus on specific points of the sequence to do some detailed work. There are a number of ways in which you can zoom into the sequence, and everyone has their personal favorite. The first method is to click on the horizontal scroll bar and drag upwards. The upward movement zooms into the sequence, and dragging downwards zooms out. To fit the sequence to the timeline view, you can click the home icon located to the bottom right of the sequence. You can also use the rectangular zoom tool by holding down the keyboard shortcut and dragging a box to zoom into the region of segments. Lastly, press Command Plus or Command Minus to zoom in and out of the sequence. The pull-down menu on the bottom right gives you various zooming options. You've already used the first one, which is the zoom home. The second is zoom only height, the third is zoom only width, and the fourth and final option is zoom to a selection of segments in the sequence. To pan the sequence left or right, you can use the horizontal scroll bar at the bottom of the timeline view. Or you could simply drag the positioner to the left or right of the sequence and the timeline view will scroll the sequence. To scroll the sequence vertically to expose more tracks, you can use the vertical scroll bar to the right of the sequence. You can also use the middle mouse wheel of a 3-button mouse or your Mac's trackpad. To modify the height of the tracks, you just go to the track indicators and click and drag them vertically. This will raise the track height, revealing more information about your clips, such as applied effects or waveforms in the audio tracks. Finally, to see more information about a clip in the sequence, or even in the media library, hold down the / keyboard shortcut and click on a segment. This will show a pop-up with all the clip's metadata, such as timecode, length, and even file path. Just by holding down the / keyboard shortcut and moving over clips, we'll update the pop-up accordingly. In the next video, we'll focus on the patch panel and see how to set it up correctly when editing.